Hello everyone, myself Dr. Mansi Zaveri, and today we learn about how to fit a straight line to the given data using the concept of curve fitting. So here the example is given as using the method of least squares, find the best fitting line to the given data, and the data of x are given as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the y data are given as 1, 3, 5, 6, 5. So here which line or which equation to be fit in a given data which is not given. So here first we assume that the line that best fits to the given data is y is equal to a plus bx, equation 1. So to write down its normal equations, what we do first we multiply equation 1 by its independent variable. Here x is independent variable and y is dependent variable on x, therefore we multiply equation 1 by x both the sides. So here we write down multiply equation 1 both sides by x. We get xy is equal to ax plus bx square. This is our equation number 2. Now to write down its normal equations, what we do here, we apply summation to the both sides of equation 1 and 2. So here we write down its normal equations. So for first normal equation, we apply summation to the both sides of equation 1. So here left side we get summation y is equal to, when we apply summation to the right side, here we get summation of a. Now summation of a is what? Summation of a is equal to a summation 1, which is equal to, here we write a n, because of summation 1 is equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to n times, which is equal to n. So here we get summation a is equal to a n. Plus summation bx, where b is a constant, therefore we write down outside this summation b summation x. Now we apply summation to the equation number 2, and here we get summation of xy on the left hand side is equal to summation ax, where a is a constant, that's why we write down outside summation a summation x, plus summation bx square is b summation x square. So these two are our normal equations, and we give these equations as number 3 and 4. You can do numbering as per your convenience. Now here we want to find out all these values, sum of y, sum of x, sum of xy, summation of x square and n. Now what is n? N is number of observations. So here we have given xy data are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We have 5 data are given, therefore here we have number of observations, n is equal to 7. Here n is equal to 5. Now we make a table to find out all these values. Here we first write down x, y values. Values of x are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The y values are 1, 3, 5, 6, 5, and now we write down x into y and then x square. So these are very simple values, we can do it without calculator. X into y, 1 into 1 is 1, 2 into 3 is 6, 3 into 5 is 15, 4 into 6 is 24, 5 into 5 is 25. So and summation x square is 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25. Then here sum of x, that is all the sum of values of x, all this values sum is 15. Sum of all values of y is 20. Summation of all x into y is equal to 71, and summation of x square is equal to all sum of all these values is equal to 55. Okay, now we get all the required values for equation 3 and 4. So we put all the values in equation 3 and 4. And before that, if you do not want to do it without using calculator, and if you wish to use the calculator, I show you how to use a calculator. So first you need to reset your calculator. So how to reset your calculator? Use shift and mode, and then place 3 for all n is equal to, then your calculator is reset. Now you can do your calculations. Now we have our datas are given, xy datas are given. So how to input these datas and how to find out all these summation values directly without making this table, because here these values are very simple. Otherwise you will not calculate these values without using calculator, right? So how to input the datas of x and y? So for that, press mode. After resetting your calculator, then press mode and then press 3 for regression. Now we want to fit a line, therefore put 1 for linear, and your calculator is reset, calculator is set to find out all these summation values. Now we input x and y datas. So first our data pair is 1 1, then 2 3, then 3 5, then 4 6, and then 5 5. So we input 1 comma 1 m plus, that is our first data, 2 comma 3 m plus, 3 comma 5 m plus, 4 comma 6 m plus, 5 comma 5 m plus. So here all the datas are inputted, and now here we see that how to find out these values directly without hand calculations. So here we press shift S sum, shift and then S sum. So the required values, for required value, if we require summation of x square, right, then press 1 for summation x square, 1 is equal to. So we get 55 for summation of x square. Now if again press shift S sum, if we require sum of x, then press 2, it is 15. So here sum of x is 15. Again shift S sum, press this button, sum of y square, which is not required. If you require, then 1 is equal to. Now we require sum of y, summation y, press 2, which is equal to, we get 20. Again press shift S sum. If you require summation of xy, then press 3 is equal to. So you get 71, which is summation of xy is 71. If you wish to skip this table, write down this, all the values directly, that summation xy is equal to 71, summation x is 15, and put that values in equation 3 and 4. Right? You can skip this table and use this scientific calculator to find out all these values. Therefore here we put these values in equation 3 and 4. Therefore from equation 3 and 4 what we get here? Here we put summation y, that is 20 is equal to 5a plus summation x is equal to 15b, and another equation summation xy is 71 is equal to 15a plus 55b. So to find the values of a and b, we can cancel out either a or b. So cancellation of a is very easier. We multiply equation first equation by 3 and take the subtraction. Therefore, okay, so here multiply equation first equation by 3. You can give this equation as number equation 4 and equation 5 and equation 6. So multiply equation 5 by 3 and take subtraction. We get 60 is equal to 15a plus 45b, and the second equation as it is 71 is equal to 15a plus 55b, and we take the subtraction. Therefore 15a is cancelled out. This is minus 11 is equal to minus 10b. Therefore b is equal to minus 11 by minus 10, which is equal to minus minus will be plus. Therefore it is 1.1. Now you can put the value of b either in equation 5 or equation 6 and we get the value of a. So here we use equation 5. Therefore from equation 5 we get, so here we use equation 5. Equation 5 is 20 is equal to 5a plus 15 into b is 1.1, right? Therefore a is equal to, if you do the calculations, we get a is equal to 3.5, and therefore a is equal to 3.5 by 5, and which is equal to 0.7. So here we get value of a is equal to 0.7, and we get the value of b is equal to 1.1. Now what is our assumed equation of line? Our assumed equation of line is y is equal to a plus bx. Therefore we put the values of a and b in equation 1, and here we write down that from 1 y is equal to a plus bx is equal to 0.7 plus 1.1x. So this is our line that best fits to our given data of x and y. Now by using calculator, how to find out this value of a and b, otherwise how you can check that whether your values of a and b are right or wrong. So for that we have fitted the data. Now use the key shift as variation, and here you get different values. Use this keys here for a, press 1, which is equal to 0.7 that we get here. A is equal to 0.7, and again shift as variation for b, press 2, that is equal to 1.1 that we already find out, right? So using calculator you can verify that your equation is right or wrong. But this calculator only calculates for equation y is equal to a plus bx. here we have assumed that y is equal to a plus bx. We have assumed this equation. But if you are given that fit the curve y is equal to ax plus b, right? Try to understand. If you are given that fit the curve y is equal to ax plus b, here calculator fits y is equal to a plus bx, and if you are given that fit the curve y equal to ax plus b, then whatever the answer you get, here b is replaced by a and a is replaced by b. It is a very simple and common funda that here whatever you get as a b, it will be your a, and whatever you get as a, it will be your b. That means a and b are interchanged, right? Calculator fits this equation, but if you are asking that fit this y is equal to ax plus b, then replace a and b. That is b equal to a and a equal to b. Thank you everyone.